Alright, how's it going, guys? Today I'm going to be showing y'all the first like BMX grind trick that I ever learned, and that's a feeble. So if you don't know what a feeble is, it's when your front tire and your back peg are on the ledge. So it looks like this. You see front tire and then your back peg. So obviously you have to have a peg on whichever side that you're going to grind on. So I'd recommend if you're right foot forward that you have pegs on your right side. If you're left foot forward, you have pegs on your left side. It'll just help later on once you start doing like spins out of grinds and like bar spins out of grinds and stuff like that. Just because if you have the other foot forward, you're like, you tend to spin the other way. So this just will keep things a little bit easier. Okay, so once you're ready to start learning feebles, the first step you're going to have is to find a ledge that's the right height. So the only thing you're looking for in a ledge is something that's short and it's barely taller than your peg is what I recommend. You don't just go straight for something like this. And another thing I'd recommend is something that you can't get your peg caught under. Because this one, if you ended up missing your back peg and you hopped on like this, your back peg, whenever you try to pull off, it's gonna get caught under there and that can just fling you over the bars and it's not gonna feel good. So I'd recommend something that has like a solid side, so like a ledge or a bench or something that just is flat all the way down and doesn't have a gap under it. That would be perfect. I'll show you all the ledge that I learned my first one. And another thing to look out for is the coping or whatever if it's a skate park. So if it's like a metal ledge but with only a piece of like steel coping going straight up on the side, you gotta watch out for that because if it's thin enough, it can get caught in between like the little like gap between your peg and your forks or your hub guards and just get caught in there and get stuck and yet again fling you over your bars or break something off on your bike. Obviously you don't want that to happen.
So this is the first ledge that I learned on, and as you can see, I'm going to show you an example of that coping that'll get stuck in between your peg and your frame or your hub guard. So as you can see, like there's that like gap right here, and this thing could just get stuck in there and just tear your bike apart. So I just avoid that at all costs pretty much because I've messed up a hub guard on this thing. And it's just not the best ledge. But yeah, that's about the height. It's just like barely off the ground, high enough to grind, but it did the trick to help me learn feebles.
Okay, so once you find your ledge and stuff, you're gonna have to think about the approach. So the approach that I took whenever I first learned is you go at just a little bit of an angle, maybe 10 to 15 degrees, and you're just gonna hop on there. And the way I did it when I first learned is a little different than I do it now. Whenever I first learned it, I put my back peg on first and then get my front tire on, but now I definitely get my front tire on first and then my back peg just drops on, which I think is a lot more consistent. Because that way, like once your front tire hits, you kind of like push your butt over and that'll slam your back tire against the side of the ledge that you're gonna grind and it'll drop it down. So it's up to you, and it's also different for riding rails too, but it's pretty much, it doesn't really matter which way you do it, it's just whichever way you feel most comfortable. So I'll give you an example of the feeble. If you can tell, that ledge is really wet. My front tire is on there, just shot all that water in my face. But yeah, that's what the feeble looks like. And so pretty much like the balance during the feeble, it's you just want to keep your weight centered over your bike, like you're not trying to like lean way over the ledge or out over the outside of the ledge. You're pretty much just centered right in the middle. And then once you're ready to pull off, as you can see I did that last one, I kind of just pulled my front tire up and kind of like ice picked off at the end. But you don't have to do that, honestly. Like I didn't start doing that until I was really comfortable with them. Whenever I first did it, I would do one and then just like turn off of it. So especially if it's a short ledge like this, you're not gonna have as much like time to do that. So it'll probably be easier to just pull up and go off the end. But if you do wanna like turn off to the side, I'll show you how to do that. So as you can see, not much to it. I just turned my tire once I got onto the ledge and it just took me right off. And all you have to do is pick up your front end just a little bit so you don't land nose first and you're all set. And then one last way that you can get off of the ledge is like another little fun way. If you want to like do it, the other lines and stuff, it looks good. But if you do kind of like a little bit of a nollie off, those always look cool. And that's another one of my favorite things to do out of them. Okay, so another thing to think about is how far on your tire is going to be for the grind. So I'd say the best like distance from the end of the ledge, so like distance from like here to your tire, would probably be about 3 inches. Would be, I think, optimal. Maybe 2 to 3. I'm gonna say that because if you go too far on the ledge, obviously your backpack's gonna fall off like that. And if it's not high enough, you're gonna drop it in a double peg. If you're not ready for that, that can kind of be scary. So just hop on, and then make sure you just focus on where your front tire is. There's not too much you can do for your back peg. That's all comes into play whenever you're doing your little approach. That's why you do that bit of an angle, because like once you hit the ledge, it'll kind of like even you out. Like it'll keep your body weight over the ledge. Instead of if you just hop over to the side, you could just move your front tire over too much and not your back tire enough, and then your peg will miss and it'll be a mess. So there's the steps to learning how to feeble. Just make sure you find a ledge that's a good height. Whenever you're going up to the ledge, take a medium to slow speed and hop up and put your front tire or backpack on first, whichever you feel more comfortable doing. And then just make sure your front tire is about 2 to 3 inches from the end of the ledge. That way you don't fall off or stay on and fall off the other way. And then once you're ready to pull off, you just either pick up your front end, turn off, or do that little nollie off, and that's about it. And then once you have that down, you can take that into so many other tricks. Like feebles are one of the easiest tricks to do out of. You can do like feeble easy 180s, feeble hard 180s, feeble bar, feeble manual, something else. There's just so many opportunities with feebles. It's a really important trick to know early on. So I think I covered just about everything. If y'all have any questions or anything, just let me know down in the comments and I'll answer those as soon as I can. Thanks for watching.